The splinters of Hive Fleet Behemoth that scattered from the Battle of Macragge continue to bedevil Ultramar and the wider Imperium to this day, with vast beast-like creatures that tower above and crush many below. In this video, we'll be showing you how to batch paint your Termagants in the colours of Hive Fleet Behemoth. For this video, we'll be painting three, but you can paint as many as you want in one sitting. Batch painting means painting a group of miniatures at the same time, greater for larger units like Termagants. This means we'll be painting efficiently as possible, to get your hordes on the gaming table ready to devour your enemies in no time at all. You can even use this guide for the rest of your Tyranid army. If you're new to painting, you can check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos to learn more about paints and techniques. The paints we've used are on the screen right now, and remember that we're painting to match the box art, but you can paint your models however you like. Any additional equipment we've used is also on the screen. The first thing we need to do is undercoat our models, and for this colour scheme we've used Mephiston Red, as this is the main colour of our Hive Fleet. First we'll apply a thin coat of Mephiston Red from the pot. This helps us get a uniform coat all over the model, just in case we have to tidy up any mistakes later on. One coat of this colour should be plenty, as the undercoat is already the same colour. This just gives us a slightly different finish to the spray. By applying a coat to each model in turn, this ensures we don't miss any models, and they all have plenty of time to dry. Next, we'll be shading the skin and the gun with Caraberg Crimson. Normally, we should do the shades after a lot of base paints are applied, but it's easier to fully paint the skin first so we can avoid getting this strong shade on the other colours. Just make sure you cover all over, so don't worry about being messy at this stage. We just want to make sure it doesn't pool too heavily. So use small amounts of paint and move it around. Then you can move to the next model once it's fully covered. So just keep an eye on all your Termagants at this stage, as if you don't make sure that the shade is drying evenly, you could end up with some really dark patches. If this happens, you can cover it up with Mephiston Red. After that stage, we'll dry brush with Jaquiro Orange over the skin. Just like with the shade paint, we are doing this now to avoid tidying up afterwards. By using circular motions all over, we get all of those raised areas covered and avoid those nice recesses. You can also use directional dry brushing as well to pick out any particular details like the tail or legs. Just make sure that you get all of the skin on all of your Termagants to this stage before we move on, as you want to keep using your dry brush instead of cleaning it and waiting for it to dry again, saving you lots of time. Now that all the skin is finished, we can apply Corvus Black to the carapace, joints, hooves, claws, eye sockets and the mouth. These are small details surrounded by all of that skin, so use the smallest brush you have for those areas. A small base brush is really useful for that carapace, and a small airbrush for the rest of the details. Corvus Black is a great colour for a natural, slightly warm black that you might find on Tyranids. With the black dry, now we can paint the tongues with Screamer Pink. Just a few thin coats with a small airbrush will make easy work when painting many of these details. A good tip when painting lots of details on your models is by making a list of your colours and what details they cover, so you make sure you don't miss anything. Next, we'll paint the teeth quickly with Wraithbone and a small layer brush. As we've already painted the mouth in Corvus Black, this will really help those teeth stand out even more from the model, showing us how sinister and vicious the Termagants can be. And to pick out the last small detail, we'll use Lugnath Orange for the eyes. We still want to keep the black base coat under this colour, so use a small airbrush and dot it into the eye sockets. You can always build it up rather than put too much on. You can really see the Behemoth Termagants becoming a great little unit. Now that all our colours are down, we can shade over the Corvus Black and Screamer Pink details with Nuln Oil. We don't need a lot, just enough to get into those recesses and shade nicely. So try and avoid the teeth if possible when painting the tongue, but it's not the end of the world if you do. Just tidy back over when it's dry. And we can finish off our models with a quick and easy highlight of Temple Guard Blue on the carapace and claws. With small choppy lines around the edges of the plates and a few small solid lines, we can really bring this armour to life. the chittering, dangerous life that it is. If you don't want to highlight this way, you can also dry brush this colour onto the carapace instead. And there we are, your behemoth termagants are now finished, ready to swarm and crush anything that could be consumed as biomass. You can see that our models are based using astrogranite, and if you'd like to learn more about technical paints, you can check out our video all about them. For more tutorials, tips and tricks, check out citadelcolour.com or head to your local Warhammer store where our amazing staff will be happy to help you. Well, we hope you enjoyed this video and we'll see you next time. Bye bye!